Let's begin our discussion. What do you think? Is this cultural policing with actors as the soft target? We are talking about the story of actor Vijay pulling out of the biopic on Sri Lankan cricketer Muthiah Muralidharan. I want to introduce our guest this evening. Mr. Pula Rao is a political analyst, is with us. Dr. Sumanth C. Raman, senior journalist and also a political analyst, continues to be with us. In just a short moment, we'll be joined in by two other guests. But Dr. Raman, let's begin with you. Here is a man who is the bowling coach of an IPL team right now. He's played in the IPL in this country. He's loved by Indians, possibly a lot of Indians in Tamil Nadu as well. And on the basis of pressure by a few in the fringe and the political fraternity in the Tamil Nadu giving in to the fringe, urging this actor that it will be in your interest that you go ahead and pull out of this biopic, the actor has taken a decision. Your initial comments. If this is not cultural policing, what is?
This is very, very unfortunate. And I think, the problem with this particular case is even worse than it normally is, because the movie itself hasn't been made yet. Yeah. So there is even, you cannot even say that there were objectionable scenes or there were dialogues which should not have been there or which could have created some kind of a turmoil or whatever. This is a movie that hasn't yet been made. And here we are with some fringe elements going hammer and tongs and trying to get Vijay Sethupathi, who's a very well-known actor and one of the leading stars of the Tamil film world today, to withdraw from it. And finally, I don't know whether there was a dialogue or discussion between Murali and Vijay Sethupathi on this matter. And Murali wrote this letter, asking Vijay Sethupathi not to take the risk with his career and withdraw from the film if he felt so. So yeah. I think that it is cultural. It's not just cultural policing. I would call it cultural terrorism, because this is not strong just words. Policing. And
Mr. Raman, see, yeah. there is a larger point. One is cultural policing. You can understand fringe groups, but mainstream parties in Tamil Nadu under pressure because this is election season. You've got mainstream political parties that are either complicit in their silence, or they're very openly saying, you see what you want to do, go easy, you'll be respected if you take this decision. I mean, what is this? Where is the strong denial?
One of the biggest fallacies in politics in Tamil Nadu is that the Sri Lankan Tamil issue gets a huge amount of votes, or there is a substantial vote bank. If that was the case, Mr. Vaiko would have been chief minister maybe two decades ago. Mm. So clearly, that is not a vote-catching issue. Sure. Yet, once in this era of competitive politics between DMK and AIADMK, once one party takes a stand, the other party would also want to be seen as, look, at the end of the day, massacres which happened in 2009, where thousands and thousands of innocent Tamil civilians were killed, happened because India did not intervene to save them. And who was in power? It was the UPA government in Delhi, and the DMK was very much part of it.
Yeah.
So, and
I can understand the sentiment. Obviously, it was a tragic thing to happen, and anyone will feel riled up. But to blame an actor, to blame a cricketer, I don't know. I mean, this is taking it a bit too far. Mr. Pula Rao is also with us. We also have Mr. A. Rajashekaran, lawyer and founder of Voice of Tamil Nadu, and Mr. S. Muralidharan, political analyst. Thank you so much, all of you gentlemen. I want to come to you, Mr. Pula Rao. If this is not ridiculous, then what is? And if this is found acceptable, then I think this is no different from a Tanishq sort of a situation where you will shout down anyone and the actor is the softest target.
The actor and the cricketer. And sad to say that at least in other states, the actors, the director would put up some resistance. Here there was no resistance at all. But Muralidharan has himself said, I have requested Mr. Sethupathi to withdraw.
No, but you know how these things work. No, he must have seen the outrage. See, the cricketer does not want...
I agree with Mr. Raman to some extent. It's manufactured outrage. Where is the outrage? Where is the citizen participation on this? One political party issues a statement. Then everybody says, let's be on the same side. So no one gains anything. No gain, no loss. And sadly, what has happened is this kind of attitude in Tamil Nadu has led the Sri Lankan Tamils to believe that there will be great help.
No, what I don't understand is that what I don't understand is that the ruling party at this moment,
that this support in some way is going to translate into action. It never did. And 2009 it ended. Therefore, I personally believe that Muralidharan is a great cricketer, one of the greatest cricketers in the world, and his biopic should have been
made. There should have been a political will. In fact, we would not be wrong to expect that many political parties, in fact, are ruled by actors themselves, should have come out and said that this is rubbish. Don't give in to the fringe. But you have the mainstream political parties also echoing the same sentiment. Mr. S. Muralidharan as well as Mr. Rajasekharan. Mr. Rajasekharan, let me come to you first. I want to know from you, don't you think that the political parties failed in their duty and responsibility to support the actor? Rather, what did they do? Either they were quiet or they urged him to pull out.
Sanket, see, I am for artistic freedom. I am for freedom of speech and expression. I'll make it very clear.
Yeah.
In this issue, in this particular issue, 800 movie, which is the biopic of cricketer Muralidharan, I have no problems personally with Muralidharan. But fact remains, see, there was a genocide which took place in Sri Lanka. Tamils were killed, mercilessly they were killed. And Mr. Muralidharan, who was there at that time in Sri Lanka, was just a mute spectator. He did not raise his voice or he never supported anybody. He was just a mute spectator.
Let me know when
again,
I can come to you. Yeah,
no, I'll tell you. See, he claims that he is a Sri Lankan by birth. No issues. When it comes to the emotions, sentiments and feelings of the Tamils, especially the world Tamil diaspora is not happy with what Vijay Sethupathi did in this movie because nobody knows the script. Let me be honest. I agree. But calling them fringe is not the right term. You have to understand the feelings from their own shoes. You cannot make bizarre statement and saying this is
okay,
all
fringe. Okay, Mr. Rajasekharan, tell me something. Yes. What is this? What is the? You say that they should not be called fringe. Fine, whatever you may want to call it. The extremely elite, the concerned, whatever you may want to call it. My question is this, Mr. Rajasekharan. Will you now oppose Mr. Muthaiah Muralidharan's association with IPL also? Will there be an IPL boycott of Sunrisers Hyderabad because he's the bowling coach? I mean, there has to be some limit.
Sanket, you raised a very pertinent question. I'll answer to it. See, again, it is not the biopic at the background of the war. See, you are going to say something to the people, the world Tamils, that during the war, what the life of Muralidharan was there, what he underwent, what was his struggle, all
this. How is Muralidharan responsible for the genocide, Mr. Rajasekharan? No. That's what I want to know.
Yeah, I'll tell you. See, it was Rajapakse at that time, who is the present leader and in power. And it was Gotabaya Rajapakse who was leading the army. And all this happened in front of Muralidharan's eyes. So he claims to be a Tamilian. He should have definitely protested. He should have definitely supported the Tamils, but he failed then. Today, a biopic on him.
Okay,
on
one by one. I think you've made your point.
One second. A biopic on a cricketer is fine, but not with the background of Sri Lankan war and the ethnic war, the Tamils, and other issues.
Mr. Muralidharan, I want to come to you now. Mr. Muralidharan, how far are we going to take this objection? Right? Today, you are saying that, Mr. Rajasekharan's point here is that the Tamilians are upset because Muralidharan kept quiet and they are upset that a Vijay Sethupathi accepted the role of playing Muralidharan who kept quiet. If this is not far-fetched, what is?
Sanket, not just my name, Muralidharan. We grew up in the same city in Kandy, Sri Lanka. I went to Trinity College. He went to St. Anthony's. He's 1 year junior to me. That's Muthaiah Muralidharan. Now, Muthaiah Muralidharan did not fight only the suppression during the ethnic war. When he started playing cricket, he also had so much of pressure from the Australians on the suspect action. He fought all that and got that 800 wickets. He is somebody, he's a pride of Tamil clan. He should be celebrated. Unfortunately, they have dragged him into this dirty politics without understanding what's happening in Sri Lanka. After 30 years of ethnic war, which destroyed so many dreams of youngsters who had aspirations to become whatever, all was destroyed, and that's what Sri Lanka was. And today, people in Sri Lanka are happily living together. The Sri Lankan Tamils and the Sri Lankan Sinhalese are together. See, another point is, in Sri Lanka, there are two types of Tamils. One is the Indian origins. People like Muthiah Muralidharan and myself, our ancestors went there to work in the tea gardens. And there's another clan of Sri Lankan Tamils who are the sons of the soil, who belong to the north and the eastern province, who are the LTD Prabhakaran's clan. So there is always a demarcation between these two people. It's the upcountry Tamils, who are the Indian origins, always coexisted with Sri Lankans, Sinhalese, without any problem. The war was between mainly the north and eastern province with the rest of the Sinhalese.
Sure.
This narrative was never understood by Indian politicians. They mixed it up. And what we are doing today is the same old narrative,
I think what they are trying to do is perhaps because it is something that may give them political dividends, or so they think.
Exactly.
But Dr. Raman, let me quickly come back to you. Where are the actors? One who is launching his political party for the longest time, and the other who has a political party and other political parties, where are they? Why are they not speaking for a fellow actor?
They should, but they won't, because this is entirely about politics. And look, I think the lack of understanding is huge. Mr. Muthiah Muralidharan, as Mr. Muralidharan on this show said, is a plantation Tamil. The plantation Tamils have had very little, except that they speak the same language. They are not. This is like saying an Australian and an American are the same because they both speak English. They are not the same. They don't identify with each other. And even their political representation is different.
Yeah.
The plantation Tamils to which Mr. Muralidharan belongs are represented by the CWC, the Ceylon Workers Congress. Whereas the North and the East, you have the Tamil National Alliance and the other parties there. I mean, the abominable level of ignorance on this issue does not prevent us from going and taking a position irrespective of whether it is based on fact or not. And logic has nothing to do with this.
I agree with you. Mr. Rajashekaran, please come in. You have heard what Mr. Suman has to say.
See, all this justification for a movie, that too at the backdrop of this Yelam war, Tamil war. See, first of all,
Mr. Rajashekaran, a few fringe groups.
Aided and abetted by political parties, they are going to decide. I personally have nothing against Muralidharan, let me be honest. But when it comes to the emotions and the feelings of the Tamils who were massacred by the Sri Lankan army and the present government, present leaders who are all present, and you make a movie saying that Muralidharan suffered all this, and this war was there, and you are going to create a narrative.
Mr. Rajashekaran, I want to ask you a simple question.
You make a Sinhala movie and you...
You keep saying, I have nothing personally against Muthiah Muralidharan.
Yes, absolutely.
So if you have nothing personally against him, why do you have a problem with a movie on him?
Yeah,
why?
I'll tell you. Simply because, being a Tamilian, I don't want anybody to oppose. Or justify the genocide.
Many Indians also did not speak up against what happened in Sri Lanka.
Sankhet, there is an attempt to twist the history of the genocide which happened in Sri Lanka. Muralidharan in the show is saying 30 years.
This is the same form of identity policing which is happening all over the country and unfortunately happening in Tamil Nadu as well. It cannot be looked at in any other way. And Dr. Suman C. Raman has gone a step further by calling it cultural terrorism. I don't know, that may be his term
he has used, but he doesn't understand the feelings of the Tamils. Even the world Tamils are opposing it, because you are going to twist the whole script and say Muralidharan is right and the whole genocide is right, and now the justification...
I don't know. This is very far-fetched. The the movie was on his cricketing career. It had nothing to do with genocide.
No, no, the backdrop of the war. Backdrop of the ethnic war. Backdrop of the genocide. What happened then? They are going to justify it. You will say Muralidharan suffered a bomb blast and escaped and became a hero.
How do you know, Mr. Rajshekaran? The movie is yet to be made. That's the problem. The movie is yet to be made. Mr. Rajshekaran has already declared that the whole world is out there to upset the Tamils. I don't know. I mean, I don't know how to look at this. Lest we also become insensitive and end up saying something which will hurt Mr. Rajshekaran and his likes. That's all the time we have. Thank you so much to the four of you gentlemen. We're stopping at this moment to get you our story. Thank you very much, Mr. Rajshekaran, Pula Rao, Mr. S. Muralidharan, as well as Dr. Suman Sriraman. Thank you.